Hello everyone, welcome to sqadia.com. I'm Dr. Hina Khan and today we're going to discuss a very significant topic relating to forensic psychiatry. So forensic medicine, as we all know, is dealing with the legal aspects of the medicine. So we must know that even the psychiatric illnesses have the legal aspects over here. So we're going to discuss in detail the different conditions, how do we analyze these patients over here, and the major outline would be basically how you analyze, what is the basic prospect of this forensic psychiatric interview that you're going to conduct with the detainees in a cell. So moving on, we'd be discussing the complete requirements and what are you going to focus on, the different aspects of psychiatry, for instance, the general appearance of the individual, the overall behavior, the moods, and the personality disorders that the patient might be suffering from. Moving on, we'd be discussing what is the role of the forensic practitioner when he's carrying out this interview. He or she must be well-versed with the mental health legislations under which you're working. This is very important. The diversions from the criminal justice system is again discussed over here. And how do you basically assess the risk of suicide or self-harm, deliberate self-harm that the patient might get into? Moreover, we'd be discussing the common terminologies that you're going to use for the documentation of this particular interview that you're going to carry on. Having the definitions of hallucinations, delusions, comorbidity, discussing the conditions of delirium, the prerequisites of ideas of references, and different mental disorders would be discussed over here. How do you assess passivity in the individuals? What are personality disorders, the psychopathic disorders, and along with that, the thought contents and the thought disorders would also be discussed completely over here. Having done your homework or getting the background information regarding a particular detainee that you're going to interview is very significant over here. Having the proper conduct that in which you're going to carry out this interview is very important. Introducing yourself and having a consistent style would be discussed over here. And moreover, we'd be discussing the folstein MMSE, that is the mini mental state examination, in detail over here. Assessment of the suicidal risk is a major factor while you're assessing these detainees. What are the general principles and how do you assess an episode of self-harm that has been done or that has been committed? You're going to discuss that. And along with that, any other associated factors would also be discussed in detail in this particular lecture. So if you want to watch this particular lecture, or we have thousands of other medical lectures available on our website, subscribe to our website and you can even start your free trial right now. Thank you for watching sqadia.com.